this pathetic planet from the face of the galaxy.
The Force fights with me.
Get on those gun turrets.
To me.
All Republic forces, pull back!
It is too late to retreat, Admiral. There is no escape for us. You are strong, child, but I will break you.
I'll never fall to the dark side.
This is but a taste of the dark side.
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time. Did you fall out of your bunk and hit your head? The Endar Spire is the ship we're stationed on. This ship. You probably don't even know who I am, do you? I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up! We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive. Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I heard what everyone's saying about you. You've explored the farthest reaches of the galaxy. You've visited planets I've never even heard of. People with your skills and abilities are hard to find. It's no wonder the Republic recruited you for this mission. But now's the time to prove yourself. I know you're a scout and not a soldier, but Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack. So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here. Use the right thumbstick to control the camera and the left thumbstick to move towards your footlocker. Press the A button to open your locker once it is targeted, or you can pull the left and right triggers to cycle between targets until the footlocker is highlighted. Then press the A button to open it. Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own. Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override codes. You'll have to use me to unlock the door. You always control the leader of the party. You can switch who is the party leader by pressing the black button. Press the black button now to switch me to the party leader, then use me to open the door. Simply target the door, then press the A button to open. Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
This is cosSLAY. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge!
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated. You can access your journal, map, and other important menus by pressing the Start button. You can then pull the left trigger to scroll through the menus listed on the tabs at the top of the screen. That door is locked, and I don't have the codes to open it. You'll have to use your security skill on it if we want to get past. Target the door using the thumbsticks or the triggers. When the targeting circle is focused on the door, you'll see that the icons in the action menu at the bottom left of the screen have changed. Use the directional pad to cycle through the action until security is highlighted. Then press the A button. Remember, the security icon only appears if you're controlling a character with the security skill. Sith must be the advanced boarding party for the Republic! feeling that won't be our last battle with the Sith. Good thing we have med packs to heal our wounds. It might be a good idea to use one now before our next battle. To use an item like a med pack, or to use a feat, skill, or force power, you'll need to know how to use your action menu. In the lower left of the screen, you'll see a list of icons. This is your action menu. You can cycle left and right through these icons at any time using the directional pad. The icons in your action menu will change depending on whether your targeting circle is on a door, a container, a friendly creature, or an enemy. Press the A button to activate a highlighted icon. The icon on the far left is always the default action for the target. Open for doors or containers, dialogue for friends, and attack for enemies. The second icon shows your feats and skills. The fourth icon is for offensive items like grenades. The icon on the far right shows defensive items like med packs. And the fifth shows defensive force powers like heal. The third icon is offensive force powers like choke and lightning. First, use the black button to take control of the injured character. Use the directional pad to cycle left or right through the icons in the action menu until you see med pack in the information box. Notice the flashing up and down arrows on this icon. This means you have more than one available option for this icon. You must choose between a med pack and an advanced med pack. Use the directional pad to scroll up or down to switch between your med pack and your advanced med pack. Press the A button to use the selected item on the character you currently control.
Jedi, this fight is too much for us. We better stay back. All we do is get in the way. That was
was one of the Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, we could have used her help.
Is not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way too.
The Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Bastila is not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way too.
The Sith want Bastila alive.
Press the start button to bring up your menus. Then pull the triggers to cycle through the screens until you reach the character record page. Then follow the instructions on the screen.
Behind here.
Damn, another dark Jedi. I'll try to hold him off. You get to the escape pods. Go!
This is cosSLAY on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods.
Thank you.
There's a whole squad of Sith troopers on the other side of that door. You need to find some way to thin their numbers. You could reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you, if you have enough repair parts. Or you could use computer spikes to slice into the terminal and use the Endar Spire's security systems against the Sith.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below. I'm a soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left in the Endar Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on, there'll be time for questions later. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on! There'll be time for questions later.
Good to see you up instead of thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. Was wondering if you were ever gonna wake up.
I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire.
I was with you on the escape pod, do you remember? We've been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. Try not to worry, we're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. You were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site and all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone. You don't have to thank me. I've
never abandoned anyone on a mission, and I'm not about to start now. Besides, I'm gonna need your help.
Terrace is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet, they've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a raw recruit. But it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're gonna find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves. That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Endor Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here on Terrace. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her. Bastila is no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. Often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. Of course, there are limits to what she can do, but from what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she never had a chance to use her battle meditation. Like us, she barely got out alive. I don't, but Bastila's young, and she has a powerful command of the Force. We survived the crash landing, so I'm willing to bet that she may have too. Besides, what's the alternative? I mean, if she's dead, then no one can stop Malak and his Sith from wiping out the Republic, and I'd rather operate on the assumption that she survived. Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers have mastered the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. I doubt anyone's specifically looking for us anymore. We're not that important. But if we're careful, we can move about the planet without attracting notice, a luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how vital she is to the war effort. Bastila's no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. And often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. But there are limits to what she can do. From what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she probably never even had a chance to use her power. I'm guessing she barely got out alive, and now she's trapped here just as we are. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help, and we'll probably need hers. You mean, besides a chance to get off this planet before the Sith find you, do you have any idea what the Sith do to prisoners of war? Good. We're gonna need to work together if we're gonna survive. While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple escape pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place. We don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed. I'll tell you whatever I can, though I don't know how much help it'll be. Everything I know about Malak is pretty much common knowledge. He escaped the trap that killed Darth Revan, his Sith master. With Revan's death, Malak became the new Dark Lord. It's obvious that Malak's a ruthless tyrant who'll crush anyone who stands in his way, just like Revan was. Experience has shown that the Sith won't stop until the Republic lies in ruins. Malak and his Sith don't respect anything except raw, brutal power. It's hard to imagine how someone who used to be a Jedi could become such a monster. Malak and Revan were once both part of the Jedi Order, but they were young and headstrong, and against the wishes of the Council, they went to battle the Mandalorians on the Outer Rim. Something happened out there. Something corrupted them and drew them over to the dark side. Or maybe there was something rotten inside them all along. I don't know. They formed an army of ex-Republic soldiers and Jedi who'd fallen to the dark side, with Revan at their head, until Revan was killed by Bastila's Jedi strike team. But even that didn't slow the Sith down. Malak just stepped in and assumed Revan's role. He took control of the Sith Armada and resumed the bloody conquest of the Outer Worlds. Well, I hope you're right. But the Republic hasn't been able to stop them so far, even with the support of the Jedi Council. I think Bastila may be the galaxy's last hope. Taurus was once a magnificent planet-wide metropolis of towering skyscrapers, but that was a long time ago. The upper city where the rich citizens live is still pretty safe. If it wasn't for the Sith occupation and the planet-wide quarantine, it might not even be a bad place to live. But farther down, things have degenerated. The lower city is nothing but a slum overrun by swoop bike gangs waging a never-ending war for control. And the undercity is, well, it's even worse. The lowest level of Terrace is a wasteland overrun by rat ghouls, mindless, diseased mutants that attack on sight. I've already entered all this info into your datapad journal. I understand why you want to know more about me. I kind of get the feeling we'll be spending a lot of time together over the next while. But this isn't really the best time for long introductions. We should stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time for that later. Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the upper city. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. It can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila, not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out. Yes, what's on your mind? You got it.
Okay, you alien scum. Everybody get up against the wall. This is a raid. That's how we should deal with smart mouth aliens. Now the rest of you get up against the wall before I lose my temper again. Hey, what's this? Humans hiding out with aliens? They're Republic fugitives. Attack!
Hey there, watch where you're walking. I just cleaned those floors. Well, all right then, no hard feelings. My name's Kadir. I'm the janitor for this building. You must be the new tenant here, right? Never thought they'd rent that abandoned apartment. You look like an off-worlder. What happened? You get stuck here because of the quarantine? Can't see any other reason someone would want to rent that old apartment. Don't know how much I can tell you, but seeing as how you're new here, I guess I could try and help you out. Decent enough place to live, I guess, except for the lower levels. That's where the swoop gangs hang out. Just stay in Upper City and you'll be fine. You also might want to check out the cantina. I used to go there when I was younger. Good place to get a drink and find out what's going on in Upper City. Just keep following the apartment complex ring until you come to the elevator. It'll take you out to the upper streets there. And from there, just head south a ways. You can't miss it. Don't know how much I can tell you, but... not much of an issue for me, you know. I ain't never left Tars, and I ain't never gonna. A lot of other folks are sure riled up about it, but I don't really know much about it. I prefer to keep to myself, mostly. But there's plenty of people at the cantina who'll be more than happy to tell you what they think about the Sith and their quarantine. Don't know how much I can tell you, but... I should get back to work anyway. I'll probably see you around. I'm here most of the time. The building doesn't clean itself, you know.
No problem. Got it.
Cha-ching. chika ton mulaka wata yuma ka wama hona nek ashanti dun unumuni patoka wana kuna besi chinga kala multonki.
Una boda ni un kisma toma. Chuk ning nang kong da murira ra pes. Wana kuna besi chinga murira. Chuk ning ba nong kong nek.
Dwoyo. And keep behind Gorupio.
Rama na praka donko tsercha chupa panki.
Tong hait wam jiji jum blumpa. Nita poe tikito. Dolpa da bongwaleo gandona chuchut.
Runda di hotonga kun hankabi. Wana kun bez ching palamule tonking ba nunotek.
Chi gratu loda bograshi oniu kompa chin tombo muchuba loda ni takun takum jus tak miki grabul mogo kachichu ita bodunga dolba bank wale oganda naru chuchut.
And I can tell you from experience that they aren't any good at all against a simple vibroblade. That's why the Republic has been training soldiers in hand to hand and melee combat.
Tong hait wam jiji jom blumpa. Nita poe tikito. Dolpa da bongwaleo gandona chuchut. Kachi chu ita dundonga. Yuma lita kuto tun. Jila mulane ni dupobo. Wonga kumbis jang ba mulira. Ta kum jus tak miki grabul mogo. Kachi chu ita bodunga. Dolba bank waleo ganda naru chuchut. Mogesha punka bola wana chikne. Pamule slimo chi gratu loda bograshi oniu kompa chintumbo muchuba. Loda nita kun. Ita patiso batua ktolpa da pongwale kando nangugu chuchut. Kava dunku pelio botenya. Bonanai kuchu. Hawaga boska chokol.
Runda di hotonga kun hankabi. Wana kun bez ching palamule tonking ba nunotek? Tuk tong abog sha umni nang? Wanga kun bez keng?
Tag bez jubonko kokimak panka. Ching palachiska mule tunarana nu prata donko sichar duma wamama tus keba toma. Nisha julorcha kinguno bulera jikun. Chan shok bulara. Umrao chiska duchi. On chuban jiska yanki. Titoke gratun kun chichakun king kacha chonobra. Bogra wala no tumbacha. Nechi chuna chubaching lorda itakun.
We tam. Boragatong, mulira ashang turung ni na potata tuanga chun tize. Igrutu haga jijiwa. Watajuma wana hu wama hulhu na tek.
Chi gratu loda pograshi oniu kompa chin tombo muchuba. Loda nita kun. Ita patisa batua kachatu tong. Muchishak pakat. Kie nono nama paole rachikun. Achuta, wonga kun bis dolpi kikuyana. Tong patugas mak.
Ever since the Sith quarantine, Javiar's cantina is packed with off-worlders. It never used to be that busy.
Yes, what's on your mind?
You got it.
Yes, what's on your mind?
Terrace? Well, the planet's all one big city, but its golden years are long past. And things have gotten worse since the Sith occupied it. From what I hear, the wealthy live on the tops of all the tall towers, and if you're poor, you live down in the shadows. And it gets worse the lower you go. Well, that's all I can think of, at any rate. Me? Well, I've been a star pilot for the Republic for years. Seen more than my share of wars. I fought in the Mandalorian Wars before all this started. But with all that, I've never experienced anything like the slaughter these Sith animals can unleash. Not even the Mandalorians were that senseless. My homeworld was one of the first planets to fall to Malak's fleet. The Sith bombed it into submission, and there wasn't a damn thing our Republic forces could do to stop them. I'm just a soldier. I go where the fleet admirals tell me to. I follow my orders and I do my duty. It's just... It doesn't seem right that doing that means I failed them. I didn't. That's not what I mean. I mean, I'm sorry, I'm not making much sense, am I? You probably mean well with your questions. I'm just not accustomed to talking about my past very much. At all, actually. I'm more used to taking action. Keeping my mind focused on the business at hand. So let's just do that. If you have more questions, ask them later.
Hello there. I haven't seen you in my shop before. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Kebla Yurt. Welcome to the Equipment Emporium. You looking to buy some supplies? My shop's the largest one in all of Upper Terrace. Best selection on the planet. Whatever you need, I've got. Well, mostly.
Mostly? What do you mean by that?
The Sith confiscated all my heavy weapons, and they impounded all my ships and swoop bikes. But I've still got a real nice selection, if you're interested. Anything I can do to help a potential customer out. What do you want to know? I heard a couple of pods crash down in the Undercity. I bet the crash sites have already been stripped clean by the Sith, though. Unless the swoop gangs or Davix men got there first. I don't have anything good to say about those swoop gangs. Zooming around on their swoop bikes, terrorizing the lower city like a bunch of animals. Things weren't so bad when the Hidden Bex were running the show. But ever since the rise of the Black Vulcar Gang, the lower city has been nothing short of a war zone. The Sith haven't even bothered trying to maintain order down there. And I heard a rumor that Davik's own people are having problems with the Black Vulcars now. Oh, Davik's a legitimate businessman, if you get my drift. Smuggling, slaving, extortion. Mm-hmm. They say he's a member of the Exchange, you know, the big intergalactic criminal organization.
Well, I've heard of the Exchange. Bad organization to cross.
But if anyone has blockade-breaking ships, however, it's them.
I have to pay him a protection fee every month, but it's reasonable. And I get most of my inventory through Davik and his suppliers. So I'm just smart enough not to ask where it came from, you understand? Davik hates the Sith as much as anybody. The quarantine has put a real dent in his operations, too. But he's keeping a low profile as long as the occupation lasts. Davik stays out of the way, and the Sith don't bother him. The swoop gangs could learn a thing or two from this tidy little arrangement instead of always going after each other. It's not smart to say bad things about the people in power, if you get my meaning. I just wish the Sith would ease up on the quarantine, though. They're killing my business. I can't say I like having them here in Upper City, but it could be worse, and we're still a lot better off than the Lower City, what with those swoop gangs and all. Oh, you're one of those off-worlders, aren't you? Come to Terrace for a short business trip and end up stuck here because of the Sith quarantine, right? Oh, you can't be too happy. Trapped on an unfamiliar world and all. But Terrace isn't so bad, as long as you stay in the Upper City. Just try to avoid the Sith. And stay out of the Lower City. The swoop gangs are totally out of control. Even Davik's men are having trouble down there. Good day to you, then. Remember to come back to my shop if you ever need any supplies. Welcome to the equip... just so you know, the prices on the items are final. No bargaining here. This isn't a swap meet, okay? I only deal in top-notch stuff.
Don't you just love watching the Kazakh players? All that strategy, all those credits. It's enough to make a girl get all flushed.
What do you want? Have you come here just to bother me, or do you wish to test yourself against the best Kazakh player on Taurus? Questions? I don't come here to answer questions. If you want to play Kazakh, then let's play. If not, then quit crowding my gambling table. My name is Niklos. I'm the unofficial champion of the Kazakh circuit here on Taurus. If you don't mind losing your wager, we could play a few hands. If you ever wish to test yourself against the best Kazakh player on Taurus, you know where to find me.
Hello there, youngster. You interested in buying the Kazakh deck of an old man looking to get out of the gambling game? Just 50 credits and I'll sell you all my cards. I'll even throw in a free lesson to boot. It's a great deal, if you can afford it. Don't get me wrong. The game's been good to me over the years. I've traveled the span of the galaxy, from the core worlds to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rim. I've won countless fortunes, and lost countless more. But that was long ago. Things have changed. Gambling is a young man's game. That's why I'm looking to get out. My offer still stands. 50 credits get you my old Kazakh deck and a free lesson. A great offer if you can afford it. Of course, of course. No sense in a youngster like you wasting your days away with an old man in a dingy bar. But if you ever want to chat, you know where to find me.
Hi there. I haven't seen you around before. Of course, they don't give us Sith officers from the military base much time off. I'm off duty right now, so I'm not in uniform. My name is Sana, junior officer, first class with the Sith Occupation Force. I'm actually a little surprised you're talking to me at all. Most of the people here on Taris can't stand us Sith. It can make this job pretty lonely. That's true, but people don't appreciate what we've done for them. We could have slapped a curfew on this whole planet, but we didn't. You know, it's like everyone on this backwater planet is in a permanent bad mood. Don't they know we have to make the best of things? Exactly, it's all about attitude. I didn't ask to be assigned to this backwater planet, but I try to make the best of it. It's pretty easy to get depressed on an assignment like this, but we do what we can to keep our spirits up. That's true. It's nice to meet someone who understands what I'm going through. It's good to talk about this stuff. It gets pretty lonely up at the military base. I have to get going soon. I've got a ship to the military base, but some of us junior Sith officers are having a party tonight to blow off some steam. I'd really like to see you again. Why don't you drop by the party? I'll show you where it is on your map. Don't be late. We're starting right after our shifts end. Most of us won't even be going back to the base to lock up our uniforms. I look forward to seeing you there.
What? Why are you speaking to me? Can't you tell from my clothing that I'm of the nobility? Get away from me. I can't be seen talking with a common rabble. It wouldn't be proper for a man of my standing.
No hard feelings, my good man, but I can't really talk with you right now. It's difficult enough to draw the interest of the ladies in this establishment as it is. Surely you understand what I'm talking about. I'd guess you've experienced many lonely evenings, something I'm hoping to avoid tonight.
Mucho shakapanka. Ye ki kun no ba mula draki chichon.
Everyone's worried the Sith will come in here and shut this place down. Can you imagine how dull it would be if we didn't have any music on Taris?
This Teresian ale is fantastic. We should have conquered this planet ages ago.
Where did you get those clothes? A trash compactor in the lower city? And where are those drinks we ordered?
Careful what you say. I get the feeling this spoiled brat could cause us more trouble than she's worth.
Why is the help here so incompetent? One word from Daddy and I could get you fired. That's better. Now, hurry up with our order.
And here are your drinks, Miss Lavin. I apologize for the delay.
Don't bother me. I don't speak to the help.
I can't believe we couldn't get arena tickets for this match. Now we'll have to watch the duel on the view screen.
Who cares? It's Duncan and Gurlon fighting. It's not like we're gonna miss anything good.
Shh, they're about to start. So quit complaining and just watch the view screen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I draw your attention to the dueling ring. Here, two combatants will battle for your viewing and gambling enjoyment. Now, I hope all your bets are down because we're ready to roll. In this corner, I give you Gurlon Two-Finger. And over here, looking to climb the ranks yet again, is the ever-persistent Deadeye Duncan. And to nobody's great surprise, Deadeye is down again. Don't worry, folks. He's just unconscious. as usual. Our medics will have him up and about in a bit. Well, that was quick, wasn't it? So I give you the winner, Gerlon Two Fingers.
I haven't seen you around here before. You looking to step into the duel ring? Or did you just come to watch? What? Why are you here if you don't even know what the dueling ring is? I don't have time to answer your questions. I need to stay focused for my next match. Maybe Azure can help you out. He's the hut over there in the corner. He arranges all the duels.
Vibroblades and blasters? And nobody ever dies. How come I get the feeling you're trying to take us for a ride?
Chioka con molera. Quien conjo pesha. No va molera ji. Chani yon tora unchi. Aita dia. Pula una chimek. Va molera slimo anga kubiskin. Ha! Chachis katon puta. Kasabu baka. Ho 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 ho. Mocha odonga. Ya fulki. Tumbatura smakilia. Tava pudu. Tunera nanopra.
Leave me alone. I'm not giving out any auto prints to my fans today. What? You don't recognize me? I'm Bendix Starkiller, the most famous blaster slinger on Taurus. Over 100 duels without a loss. Every one of them a death match. I'm retired now. Once death matches became illegal, I just got bored with the game. I got no interest in using stun blasters. There was nobody left to challenge me anyway. I've been watching these new kids in the ring, but I haven't found anyone worth my notice so far. Still, if someone could beat all these other pretenders, I might give them a shot. Off with you then. I'm done with this conversation anyway.
What? Can't you see I'm busy with my duties? Go talk to Zelka if you need something.
I see from your appearance that you are an off-worlder. Still, you're welcome here. I'll not have it said that Zelka Foran refused to help somebody just because they weren't a citizen of Terrace. Do you require healing or medical supplies? I can treat almost any injury or ailment right here at the medical facility. Except the rat ghoul disease, of course. The terrible affliction has plagued Terrace for many generations. It is spread by the rat ghouls, horrible monsters that live in the Undercity below Terrace's great skyscrapers. Prolonged exposure to the Undercity breeds the disease, and those infected will eventually mutate into rat ghouls themselves, becoming mindless beasts that feed on the flesh of others. There is no antidote for the disease, though I heard the Republic scientists at the military base here on Terrace were close to perfecting a cure. Then the Sith arrived. They overran the military base, and now they refuse to allow anyone access to the laboratories inside. The Sith are keeping all the serum for the patrols they send into the Undercity. If I could just get my hands on a sample of that serum, the rat ghoul disease could be wiped from the face of Terrace forever. But I don't see how that's going to happen. I don't see how anyone could get their hands on that serum. The military base is crawling with Sith guards. Breaking in there would be a suicide mission. I suppose the Sith patrols in the Undercity might have a sample of the serum on them, if they hadn't already used it because of a rat ghoul infection. But I doubt a patrol would just hand the serum over, and nobody is stupid enough to attack one of the Sith patrols, even in the Undercity. Please, don't say that! If the Sith hear you, they might think I'm suggesting you start attacking their patrols. They could shut me down. I only mentioned the serum because you asked. I don't actually expect anyone to get me the serum. Now, is there anything else I can do for you? Goodbye, and good health to you. If you ever need any medical aid or treatment, you know where to find me.
Psst, you there. Wait a minute. I need to talk to you about the rat ghoul serum. I've got an offer for you you might want to hear. Zelka isn't the only one who wants to get his hands on the rat ghoul serum. Davik Kang will pay you 10 times what Zelka can if you can get the cure. Oh, come on. Everybody knows who Davik Kang is. He's the big boss around here. Gambling, smuggling, extortion. He's got a piece of all the action on Terrace. Davik's interested in anything that can turn a profit. He could make a fortune selling the serum to anyone infected with the disease. Not like Zelka, who'll practically give it away. Look, Zelka can't afford to pay me much. If you sell the serum to Davik, I can probably get a nice finder's fee for directing you to him. I'll just deny it. Who's Zelka gonna believe? Me? Or some off-world stranger? Now be smart about this. You'll get a better deal selling to Davik.
And then only the rich could afford the cure. Just let the poor suffer, right?
If you find the rat ghoul serum, just take it to Zax in the Lower City Bounty Office. He works for Davik. He'll pay you what that cure is really worth.
Welcome back. Goodbye.
Davik says you missed your last payment.
Here, I've got 50 credits, a down payment. That should buy me some time, right?
Sorry, you're out of time. Now it's all or nothing. Davik can't have people not paying his debts.
But I don't have that much. How can I give you credits I don't have? No! Help!
Somebody help! They're going to kill me!
I know we have to be careful about drawing attention to ourselves, but are we gonna just let them drag this guy off?
Hold on a second. Looks like we got ourselves a witness here.
Thank you. I owe you my life. Those bounty hunters are going to take me away and kill me. My wife warned me not to take a loan from Davik. Now I can't pay him back. It's not good to owe a crime lord money. He'll just keep sending more bounty hunters after me till I'm dead. You already helped me by saving me from those bounty hunters, so unless you have a spare 100 credits to give me so I can pay off Davik, there's nothing else you can do. You're giving me 100 credits? Just like that? I don't know what to say. Thank you. Thank you.
You're giving him 100 credits? Generous.
Now I can pay off Davik. You've saved my life. Thank you. I'd better take these credits to him right away.
This planet coming to, huh? Slummy's just walking around the upper city.
Shouldn't you go to the lower cities where you belong, Slummy?
Oh, this is rich.
Yeah, like he said, these streets are for upper city citizens. You better get out of the way if you know what's good for you.
A drink? Hey! For a slummy, you ain't so bad. Come on, boys, this slummy's buying the next round.
No way, forget it. No more drinks. Rely enough as it is.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Maybe next time, slummy. Come on, fellas, let's go.
Friends and fellow humans, I bring you a warning of a great plague spreading across our planet. Please, listen to me. My name is Gorton Kolu. Will you join my cause? We must band together if we are to stop the spread of vermin and scum throughout Taris. I am speaking of the hideous-looking aliens who walk the world of Taris. The Wookiees and Ithorians and Rhodians and Bith, all of them. Listen, friend, for these are dark times. That is why I, Gorton Kolu, have formed the Anti-Alien League. The time has come for action. We cannot sit idly by while aliens blight our glorious planet. You are like all the rest. You will not see the truth. On the day of reckoning, you will suffer with the rest of the alien lovers.
Come on, we should keep moving. Kook or no, people like him can make trouble for us.
The evil walks among us. The enemy is here. We must act now before we are overrun with the vermin invaders.
King Kunshi Kakchin Awana Wamata Nishi La Chorga King Kun Palamula Reji Chingpala Niska Mule Dun Rata Tigin Podranko the Sarcha Doma Wana Kundatama with Timembo Rank Thong Mule Ra on Shaturing Ni Patoka Wanga Chonzi Tse
Kipuna Bona Nakichu King Ba Mule Ra Dwana Tong King Bano Kudnok Neck
You'd think people would be a little more tolerant of others in this day and age. I guess stupidity and ignorance will never go out of style.
Genchopa chawi tichok twiz yun kun watu yama kama wuna henak nek bugra shak kunti chiwa chawa dong abuk shami nonok chinapala mule tong ki ba non tontek dun ni chachon kun ne mule brabast.
King Kunshi Kakchin Awana Wamata Nishi La Chorga King Kun Palamula Reji Chingpala Niska Mule Dun Rata Tigin Podranko the Sarcha Doma Wana Kondatama Kuyami Jvuk Chikchita Na Patogta Yafulke Gogala Jiji Kawana Bora Atugawa Kanki Do Rakun Watimi Alabola.
Kakin cha na guat na bon con, wanakumbes chi pala mulek tonki pa na nonek tu nikton chun chun ke nemolek ra. Bona na kachu, kicha badwang, wanga kum kiba bu mulera kakin chak nawa gawa bakon, tonk kiba nukunek. Tonga book sha na mucha shakapaka ye ki kun no ba mula draki chichon. Tonga book sha nak nong kin kun shin shi.
Off limits. Only Sith patrols and those with proper authorization are allowed into the lower city. It's obvious from the way you're dressed that you're not one of the Sith patrols, so unless you have the authorization papers, you must move along. If you were supposed to have them, you'd know where to get them. Now quit wasting my time and move along. I'm not here to give you information. I work for the Sith, not the TARDIS Tourist Board. Now just move along, unless you have the proper authorization papers.
plague spreads through our streets. We cannot sit idle as bombs and vex our society.
Please, please don't hurt me. You don't have to kill me. I'll have Davik's money if he just gives me a little more time. Please, I don't want to die. Here, I've got 50 credits on me. That's all I've got. It's yours. Just don't tell Davik where I'm hiding, okay? I'm begging you. You mean you're not here to kill me? But I thought you were one of Davik's bounty hunters. If you're not here to kill me, what do you want? I don't think anyone can help me. I owe Davik money, and I was late with the payment. So he went to Zach's in the bounty office and put a price on my head. I've been hiding here ever since. But sooner or later, someone will find me. Unless I somehow come up with another 200 credits, I'm a dead man. Thank you. You've saved my life. At least until one of Davik's bounty hunters finds me.
Hey, you made it. I was beginning to wonder if you were going to show. The party's in full swing. Come on in. You have to try this Teresian ale. It's fantastic. We should have conquered this planet ages ago.
Careful, Sana. That wine's got quite the kick. A couple more bottles and we'll all be passed out on the floor.
Who cares? We're not on duty tomorrow. Let's live a little. Come on, drink up.
Don't hurt my family. Look, just take what you want and get out.
What do you want now? You're not going to tell Davik's bounty hunters where I'm hiding, are you? I don't think anyone can help me. I owe Davik money, and I've been hiding here ever. You'd give 200 credits to a stranger just to help them out? I don't believe it. Well, thank you.
Wow, that sure was generous of you. I just hope we don't end up needing those credits later on.
Now I can pay off Davik. Oh, thank you. You've saved my life. Oh, I better go give this to Davik right away.
Listen to me, people. There is a terrible scourge sweeping our planet. Heed my warning before it is too late.
Another patrol heading down to the lower city, eh? Well, good luck. I've heard it's pretty rough down there. There's a big swoop gang war going on, you know. You better watch yourself. Those gangs will take a shot at anyone, even us. It's too bad we don't have the manpower just to sweep those slums clean.
Kabadumpa kunba yiya moka paata!
Chuta! Yun patisa!
Kipona! Kabadumpa kunba yiya moka paata! Jiyoka kutumpa kunba yiya!
Sure.
Chiwi aita ka chong chicha. Agi inko tu.
Chi gratulo da pograshi onni un compa cintongo mutuba. Lo da dita kun. Ida patisa batua kacha tutonga.
Baka chikun ida hodonga. Yiking. Lunda di hodonga kun hunkabi.
Greetings, stranger. My name is Gelrud. Are you a Pazak player by chance? A simple misunderstanding. Some of the other Pazak players don't understand the finer points of the game. So what if I win 15 matches in a row? That doesn't mean I cheat. There's no justice. My lucky Pazak deck was confiscated and I was banned from the upper cantina. Since then, I've been desperate to find a match. If you're ever looking for a match and you get tired of posturing in the upper cantina, just come down here and find me. I'll play you anytime.
Go away.
Jiska nichu. Kimba muli rad wana ji. Kimba no kun nixet abon. Kakin cha nawa bagaon. Tun abo shun ni chun chi.
Kipuna. Kava tumpa kurpa yiya mokapa ata. Chiyoka kutumpa kurpa yiya.
One.
Oska. Jiska nichu. The hoopa botenya go jiji piti.
Kipuna. Kava tumpa ku palea muka bata. Jiyoka ku tumpa ku palea.
Two.
Jiyoka ku. Kimba muli ra tuana ji. Ku yami juski chika nai. Uba baska duana chichopa muska. Jiska da soki kupa bona na chachu.
Tune pudu. Ranu prata dongo shirkasha. Tum a pike.
Three. Go away. One. Smart.
This game war is getting out of hand. Valkyrs aren't just attacking the hidden Bex anymore. They go after everyone.
Huh? What? Oh, sorry. I didn't see you there. My attention was kind of focused on the Twi'lek dancers. Look at them waggle those head tails. I don't normally go for these alien girls, but I've had some bad experiences with my own species lately. Maybe it's time for a change. Know what I mean? My name's Holden. Maybe you've heard of me. I work for Davik Kang. I'm one of his top couriers. Davik's always sending me off planet to deliver and bring back packages. He knows you can trust me to follow my orders to the letter. Plus, I used to be an intergalactic customs agent, so I know all the tricks they use to catch smugglers. That gives me the edge I need on my courier runs. It's not like it's some big secret. It's kind of hard for Davik to keep a low profile when he belongs to a big intergalactic crime syndicate like the Exchange. Davik's ship is the fastest one in the entire quadrant, but even the Ebonhawk can't get off Taurus until the quarantine is lifted. The Sith fleet has the planet surrounded. Any ship leaving orbit without proper access codes will be disintegrated by the Sith auto-targeting laser cannons, and those codes are locked safely away in the military base. Davik's pretty upset about it. His smuggling operation isn't making any money. But even with his underworld connections, he can't get his hands on those codes. It's not like it's some big secret. It's kind of hard for Davik to keep a low profile when he belongs to a big intergalactic crime syndicate like the Exchange. Fine by me. That means I get to go back to enjoying the dancing girls.
I told you to leave me alone. So give me some space, bug eye. Your breath smells like Bantha Poodoo.
Kuyami, Juski, Chika Nai. Tong Patoga Smaktilia. Tabis, Dubon, Kuki.
Who you calling little girl, Chuba Face?
Ubabatu Konchi. She's got a soggy Koopa Bona na Chachu.
Just a sec, boys. Sawbar, a little help here? I need you to rip the legs off some insects. Quit complaining. You can finish eating later. Besides, you need the exercise, so get over here.
Kiyokaku! Kimba muli ra guanaji! Kuyami juski chika nai! Uba baska duana chichopa muska! Jiska da soki kupa bona na chachu!
You got a problem with me? Then you got a problem with Big Z. So unless you want to take on my furry friend, I suggest you greenies hop on out of here.
Chubasa! Kimba muli ra guanaji! Kaba volpa murji guma ya!
Hey, relax, Big Z. No need to be rude. Sorry about that. But Wookiees ain't much for conversation, you know? Say, I don't recognize you, and I know pretty much everyone in the Lower City. You must be new down here. I guess that makes me and Big Z your official welcoming committee. It's not that strange. Most aliens can speak basic, they just prefer to use their own language. But I grew up here on Terra, so I just sort of got used to speaking the native tongue.
You showed a lot of guts dealing with those Vulkers, kid. You got a name?
My name's Mission Veo, and this big Wookiee is my best friend Zalbar. I'd offer to give you a tour, but the streets down here aren't safe. But if there's anything else you need... We just kind of fell in together. It ain't easy on your own here in the Lower City. Everyone's always looking to push you around.
So we noticed. Still, you seem like an odd pair.
When I met up with Zalbar, it seemed like a pretty good match. I knew we could look out for each other. With my street smarts and his muscle, we make a great team. Well, you came to the right person. If you want info on Lower Terrace, I'm the one to talk to. Davik, the Lower City gangs. I even got the scoop on that bounty hunter, Kalo Nord. Davik's part of the Intergalactic Crime Syndicate, but I guess everyone knows that. But I hear he's got a new ship for his smuggling operations, the Ebon Hawk. I don't know much about space travel, but I hear that ship's fast enough to break the Sith blockade. Of course, this is all just secondhand rumor.
Where would he keep it, do you know?
If Davik does have a ship, he's got it locked up in his estate. Nobody gets in there, except the people working for Davik and the Exchange. There's only two gangs worth worrying about here in the Lower City. The Black Bulkers and the Hidden Becks. Sometimes Zalbar and I hang out at the Beck base. The Becks are led by Gadden Theck. He's a good guy. Lost his sight in a swoop bike accident a few years ago, but even blind, he's a great leader. Not like that traitor Brezhik. Before he took over the Volkers, he was a Hidden Beck. Gadden considered that ungrateful space slug his adopted son. When Gadden went blind, everyone figured he'd step down and appoint Brezhik in his place. But Gadden figured Brezhik wasn't ready yet. He wanted him to wait a few years. But Brezhik was too impatient. He left to join the Volkers, and ever since, he's been waging a war to wipe Gadden and his Becks from the face of Terrace. This gang war in the Lower City is totally the Volkers' fault. They're the ones killing everything that moves out on the street. It's like they've gone insane. Kalo Nord's one of the most famous bounty hunters in the galaxy. He's killed more people than the Iridian Plague. I've seen him kill people just for trying to talk to him. He hangs around Zack's bounty office, but I don't think he's looking for work there. All the postings there are small time, way beneath a bounty hunter of his caliber. I figure Kalo's been hired by Davik to do a special job for the Exchange. I'd wager 1,000 credits that as soon as the quarantine ends, he'll be getting off this rock. You going? Yeah, this dive is pretty boring. No action around here. Come on, Big Z, let's go. Can't you think about something besides your stomach 5 minutes? Come on. We'll go see if there's anything good to eat at the Beck base.
Uchua Penki. Tony Dwamaji, human act in Inkatune, chi ita kangki chan na kilikon chi wa ita kangki ki muli ra kun king tong hi twa ma at inko tune chau baso chino muli ra ni bubo tong king ba no kun netsang patoga ya kuli ko kala gigi tingkuin ko ka tong hi twa na ji sat kat agi inko tune chuna muli ra smilia tingkuin ko ka patok Ki muli ra kun king Tong hit wama ag inko tune Topa na oto bokasa Pampa ki muli ra kun king Chang waba chip King ba no kun nik dot Ki muli ra kun Uba maska dwara chi chopa muska Kimba ni cha lora kun I yuma bat maliau no ish Kak cha chiska Topa na oto bokasa Kakin cha na wabaka on
Kava dumpa ka paliamo na pata, bona na kati umpa do punta krita. Ak ti kondo una chaba chisa wa... Kipuna, bona na kichu. Kin pa mule ra duana, don kin pa no kudnok nek. Tangabun shan omnong, wanga kun bis kin pa mula ra, choni yun tun jiji either duan... Witi membo rang thong, Muli ra on shaturing ni patoga wanga chonzi tse. Mana tota hakuchi krala bole ji chok shuntang shun kipa unopanka muli tinku ukapa topa no aska chini. King kun shi kakichin awana wamata. Nishi la chorga kin
Rundi I chawa tong bola Johnny Ku
Takum jus tak miki grabul mogo Kachichu ita bot
Runda di hotonga kun honka
Ken chopa chawi ti chok twis yun kun Watu yama kama wuna Bona na kachu Kicha badwang Wanga
Yami jus chikata na patoga ya hulki kokoga la jiji. Gawana bot atagwa. Kagedor.
King kun shi kakichin awana wamata. Nishi la chorga king kun palamona.
Miki grabul
Kavadumpa kapaliamo na pata Bona kipuna Bona na kichu Kinpa mule ra duana Don
Chikun ita hodonga.
Shagji kina lorcha watamwana. King kun shishiki.
Ucha hodonga ya fulki. Chachiska to punta kasap. Baka. Bana uto.
Mokao dang ya foki. Chachiska to punta kakaspaka. Bano uto.
Takum jus takmiki grabul mogo. Kachichu ita bodunga. Dolbabank. Waleo ganda naru.
Gigi Hakuji Lord Jakin Kuna Bamuli Rigikun Kaji Chutu with team and Borang Tong Mulira on Shaturing Ni Patoga Wanga Chon.
Kipuna Ona Nakacho Kimba Mulira Tuana. Taupa botachi chunai saudunga. Rundi haudunga ton kimba mankun. Jibedu anani bobo. Taris manaris. Ton jone ahakono. Ton abuksha umenon. Karavulpap. La Buddha na rinkis matoma. In. Gioca col molera. Quien conjo pesa. Nova molera gi. Cerriento. Taci chonai sa odunga. Tau cum giustac mi che grabi mogo. Tolpa da vunque lagando. Ci vedo anani bobo. Paris Manaris, Donjone Ahakonon, Mulera Yonumaze, Jichin Wibibuanaita Wish Mulinem.
I can't see anything wrong with getting rid of people like that, long as we don't end up on the list of their victims.
Tunira Manu Prata Tunkyo, Sercha Doma Toma, Kalaru Pamilji Kumana, Kinkon Shashi King.
Okay, I don't know about Davik's special contracts. Justice is one thing, but doing a crime lord's dirty work is something else.
Tachi chunai saudunga. Taukum justak mikegra. Labura na rinkis matona. Inkin slimo podonam. Labura na rinkis matona. Inkin slimo podona mulera chikun. Nova runde hautunga kuunkavi. In nova mulera kinkun chikun. Mucha shag pangpa. La bula na rinkis matoma. Inkin slimo. Tonga buksha unenong. La Buddha na rinkis matoma, Paris manaris, Tonjone ahakko tonba torasma. Tunira manu prata tunkyo, Sercha doma toma, Akuchi kopa. Tachi chunai saodunga, Taukum justak mike grabimo, La Buddha na rinkis matoma, Inkin slimo podona mulerachi. Rundi hautonga tonkin badman kunkek. Wanna kumbis chimp la bula na rinkis matona. Inkin slimo podona mulerachi kun. Nova rundi chioka kol molera. Kien kunjo pesha. Nova muleraji. Tomba toras. Kipuna. Ona naikacho. Kimba mulera tuana. Tawuk rundi hautonga ton kimba nankonkek. Wana kumbes. Chimpa ya muli kunu. Kachi chonai sa hautonga. Taukum justak mike grabimogo. Tortul padabungwe yagando danago chuchut. Kawanabuta awiyat tongabuksha umenong. Kawavul pamulji kumanabak mulira. Tuniran manu pratatunkyo sercha doma toma. Kawavul pamulji paris manaris. Tonjone ahak. Konon. Inkins limma podona mulerachi kun. Nova runde hatunga kun. Tumbatura. Kava pudu. Jibedu anani bobo. Tumba.
You can't just walk in here. This is the hidden back base. How do I know you're not a Vulcan spy sent to kill Gaddon Thek? A lot of people want to go inside and speak to Gaddon. He's a hero of the common folk. But the days of the hidden back's open door policy are gone. Between the Sith conquest and the Vulcan gang war, Gaddon has more enemies than he used to. We're being careful about who we let in now. Well, we do need all the help we can get. And you don't look like you're with the Vulkers or the Sith. Besides, it's not like you can do anything to harm Gaddon in the heart of his own base. Not with Zerdra watching his back. Go in and speak to Gaddon if you want. Just remember to be on your best behavior. The hidden Vex are watching you.
Hold it right there. Who are you, and what is your business with Gaddon?
Calm down, Zerdra. Nobody's going to try anything here in the middle of our own base. It would be a suicide mission.
You're too trusting, Gaddon. Brezhik and his Vulkers want you dead. Anyone we don't know is a potential threat, and it's my job to make sure you're safe.
Do you want us to start attacking strangers on sight, Zerdra? Like the Vulkers do? I will never let it come to that. Now step aside and let them pass.
As you wish. You can speak to Gaddon if you want, but I've got my eye on you. You try anything and you'll be vaporized before you can say Vulkar spy. You can speak to Gaddon if you want, but I've...
You'll have to forgive Zerdra. Ever since Brezhik and the Vulkers began this war against us, she's been a little overzealous in her security duties. The problems with the Sith haven't helped things. Zerdra seems to forget that I know how to look after myself. Now, how can I help you? The escape pods? You know, I heard the Sith have been asking around the upper city about them as well. But you don't look like you're with the Sith.
They might be spies, Gaddon. They might be working for the Sith.
Calm down, Zerdra. If the Sith thought we knew anything useful, they'd have a battalion of troops kicking down our door. No, I think this off-worlder has his own agenda. I suppose I could tell you what I know. It's not like it could do any harm to me or my gang. But it might cause problems for the Vulkers, and that's okay in my book. The Vulkers stripped those pods clean within hours after they landed. It's too bad we didn't get there first, considering what my spies reported the Vulkers found. A female Republic officer named Bastila survived the crash. We Bex don't believe in intergalactic slavery. But the Vulkers aren't so picky. They took a prisoner. Normally, the Vulkers would take a captured slave and sell them for a nice profit to Davik, or an off-world slaver. But a Republic officer is no ordinary catch.
They still think Bastila's just a Republic officer. That could work to our advantage. Maybe she'll even figure out a way to escape from the Vulker base on her own.
She's too valuable to leave with the Vulker scum at the base. Brezhik's probably got your Republic friend hidden away somewhere safe until the big swoop race. You'll never find her. I'm afraid your friend has become a pawn in Brezhik's game to take over the lower city. He's offered her up as the Vulkers' share of the prize in the annual swoop gang race. By putting up such a valuable prize, Brezhik hopes to win the loyalty of some of the smaller gangs. Their numbers will allow him to finally destroy me and my followers.
So how do you propose we go about rescuing Bastila, then? Well, we can't fight all the gangs.
The only hope you have of rescuing Bastila is to somehow win the big season opener of the swoop race. I might be able to help you with this. If you'd be willing to help us. We both have something to gain here, and much to lose. The swoop race is for the lower city gangs only. I could sponsor you as a rider for the Hiddenbecks this year. If you win the race, you'll win your friend's freedom. But first, you have to do something for me. My mechanics have developed an accelerator for a swoop engine. A bike with the accelerator installed can beat any other swoop out there. But the Vulkers stole the prototype from us. They plan to use it to guarantee a victory in this year's swoop race. I need you to break into their base and steal it back. Getting into the Vulker base won't be easy. The front doors are locked tight. But I know someone who might be able to get you in the back way. Mission Veil.
Mission? You can't be serious. She's just a kid. How is she supposed to help them with this?
Mission's explored every step of every back alley in the lower city. Plus, she knows the undercity sewers better than anyone. If anyone can get inside the Vulker base, it's her. She and her Wookiee friend Zalbar are always looking to stir up a little excitement. They like to go exploring in the Undercity, despite the dangers. Your best bet is to look for her in the Undercity, but you'll need some way past the Sith guard post at the elevator. A simple disguise might have worked on the Upper City guard, but the security down here is much tougher. You'll need the proper papers to get past him. Luckily, my gang ambushed one of the Sith patrols headed down to the Undercity. They never made it, and their security papers fell into my hands. Since we're working together now, I suppose I could give them to you in exchange for your uniforms. With the security papers, you won't need a disguise anyway. I like to be prepared. Eventually, the Sith are going to try to drive us out of the Undercity. Sith disguises might give my people the edge we need in a crucial battle. Good choice. Thanks for the uniforms. You won't need them with these security papers anyway. Now, is there anything else I can do for you? Your time would probably be better spent going after the prototype swoop engine the Vulkers stole from us. But I'll answer your questions if I can. A foreign army invades Terrace, declares martial law, and locks down all travel to and from the planet? You damn well bet I have a problem with that. If the Sith ever moved in down here, all the swoop gangs would unite against them. We'd use hit-and-run guerrilla tactics to pick them off. Their casualties would be enormous.
Don't fool yourself. The Sith would never commit to that kind of operation. They'd probably do something much more grand and deadly.
But so far, the Sith have stayed out of the lower city, and our strength is wasted on this stupid gang war. I tried to explain this to Breshik, but he and his Vulkers won't listen. Your time would probably be... When I lost my sight in the swoop bike accident, everyone assumed I would step down as leader of the Hidden Becks and let Breshik, my most trusted follower, take over. But with my ocular implants, I can still see well enough to lead this gang, and I knew Breshik wasn't ready to take over yet. Unfortunately, Breshik didn't agree with me. In a rage, he left to join our arch-rivals, the Black Vulkers. A lot of the younger gang members followed him, and soon he and his followers had taken control of the Vulker gang. Breshik is a proud man. My decision was a public humiliation for him. Maybe if I had stepped down, this gang war could have been avoided.
Don't fool yourself, Gadden. Breshik wants to control the lower city gangs. If you'd stepped down, he'd have led the Becks against the Vulkers. He wanted this war, one way or another.
I know you're right, Zerdra. Breshik won't rest until I am dead and the Becks are no more. But it's hard to accept the truth of his betrayal. Your time would probably be better. Not while the Sith quarantine is in place. Even the fastest smuggler ships can't break the blockade of the fleet surrounding the planet without the proper launch codes. Any ship leaving the Terrace atmosphere without the proper codes would be instantly disintegrated by blaster cannons fired by the Sith fleet's automated targeting systems. Feel free to come back anytime. We're not like those Vulker savages. Strangers are welcome in the Beck base.
No problem. Didn't work. problem. Didn't work. Didn't work.
You guys are behind with your payments. What do you, you think just because you're in some gang, you don't have to give Davik his cut?
Ah,
so you want to play this the hard way? Okay.
Tonipudu! Rana no prata dunk no sercha itchua penki.
Watana wama mulira. Kenjunju bashak. No bully mulira ji. Junitun turji chiwi itato. Bola una dichek. Balamure slimo wanga kun bisching.
I knew you boys would see reason. Now get out of here.
Too bad. I was looking forward to cracking some heads.
Maybe next time, Candorous. I better get this over to Davik. I'll call you if anyone else gets behind on their payments.
Those Valkers are dumber than a Coruscant granite slug. They actually think being in that pathetic little gang of theirs makes them important. Gaddon keeps his hidden Becks in line, but Brezhik's getting dreams of grandeur. If Davik's smart, he'll slap that young punk back down. I'm someone you don't want to get on the bad side of, and I'm not one for small talk. I don't have time to stick around here anyway. Davik's got me working on a special assignment.
Yes, what's on your mind? I guess I did say you could ask me questions later. Is this really necessary? No, I don't have a problem with it, really. Go ahead and interrogate me. No, I was just joking. Though you do seem to be full of questions. It's rather refreshing, to be honest. Let me ask you something first, though. I've been going through the battle aboard the Endar Spire over and over in my head since we crashed. Some things just don't add up for me. Maybe you could tell me what happened, from your perspective. True. Basta Liz is powerful as they say. She's the one who defeated Darth Revan, after all. I guess that no Jedi ability, no matter how powerful, makes up for being completely surprised and outmatched. We didn't choose that battle anyway, it got forced on us. Hell, I'm just as surprised that any of us are alive to talk about it. Come to think of it, it's more than a little surprising that you happen to be here, isn't it? I mean, just what is your position with the Republic fleet anyway? Well, that makes sense. Still, it seems a bit strange that someone who is a last-minute addition to the crew roster is one of the survivors. You were the only one. Not to mention that Bastila's party was the one who requested your transfer. The Jedi requested numerous things when they came on board. And hell, they practically took over the ship, as far as I could tell. Considering your connection to Bastila and the Jedi, whether you know it or not, your presence here seems a little convenient. I'm probably wrong, and this is probably nothing, I know. I learned a long time ago not to take things at face value ever, and I hate surprises. I mean, I have to expect the unexpected, just to be safe. Look, it has nothing to do with you personally. I don't trust anyone, and I have my reasons. And no, I'm not going to discuss them, so can we just keep our mind on more important things? Good. Like I said before, I prefer action to talk anyway.
There, civilian. Only those with official Sith business are allowed into the Undercity. Unless you've got the proper security papers, you better just turn around and go back the way you came. Let me see. Yeah, these look to be in order. Okay, you can go down if you want. Can't say I envy you, though. The Undercity is crawling with mutants. Rackgulls, they call them. If you see anything moving down there, shoot first and ask questions later.
You there, Upworlder! Anyone using this elevator has to pay the toll.
Yeah, this is our elevator. If you use it, you gotta give us something.
I don't believe this planet. Even the beggars are trying to shake us down.
5 credits! That's what it costs to use our elevator. 5 credits! We are the outcasts, banished and reviled by those who dwell above.
Here in the filth and darkness, we claw out a wretched existence, scavenging and begging just to survive long enough to see another wretched day.
This is our village. We live here in the Undercity. You have to pay us 5 credits for using our elevator. Credits, my brother! We have credits. Now we can buy food and medicine.
Hush, or the others will hear us. They'll want our credits. We have to hide them.
Go on, you two. Get out of here. I'm sorry about that. Those 2 beggars give everyone in the village a bad name. We aren't all like that, you know. Most of us are good people.
I'm sure you are, miss. It's just too bad your little welcoming committee is here to give people a bad first impression.
My name is Shalina. You're from the Upworld, aren't you? I've never seen it. I was born here in the Undercity. Is it as nice as they say up there? I've never been to the surface, but sometimes I think I can see it in my dreams. The sun, the sky, the stars. It all sounds so wonderful. Gendar, the leader of our village, tells me I should spend more time trying to improve things down here and less time dreaming about something I can never have. Maybe he's right. You probably think I'm a fool, having dreams of a place I've never even seen. But when I was little, Rukil used to tell me stories of what it was like up there. Rukil's the oldest man in the village. The kids call him Rukil Wrinkleskin, but he's a kind man. He used to tell me the greatest stories when I was a little girl. I still like to listen to his tales about the Promised Land, even though I know they're just legends, but it helps to make the Undercity seem less dark somehow. It's just a story to make little children smile. Rukil believes in it, though. Sometimes I can almost believe it myself, but then I look around and see the ugly truth. I guess we have to make the best of what we have, though. If you really want to learn more about the Promised Land, you should speak to Rukil. He's wandering around somewhere on the south side of the village. He doesn't move too far. It's hard on his bones. He's over 100 years old. The children laugh at him, and people think he's crazy because of his stories about the Promised Land, but he's really just a kind old man. You'd probably get more information from Gendar, the village leader, or maybe Rukil, but I'll tell you whatever I can. He'll be somewhere in the village. I couldn't say where for sure. He's always busy doing whatever he can to make the lives of the other villagers easier. I don't know anything about that, but maybe Gendar could help you. Sorry. Is there anything else you need? There were quite a few people from the surface marching through the village, but none of them bothered to talk to me. Gendar might know more about them. Well, I was born here for starters. My parents were outcasts, banished to the Undercity for some crime or other. They never really liked to talk about it. Everyone here is an outcast, or the descendants of one. It's tough down here, but we survive. I guess it's easier for me, since I've never known anything different. Some of the people have given up all hope. They've become bitter and depressed, but most of us are good people, despite what our ancestors may have done. Gendar could probably tell you more, or maybe Rukil. You could talk to them if you want. Oh, okay. Well, if you ever need anything, or if you just feel like talking, come back and see me. I hardly ever get a chance to speak to someone from the upworld.
What?
Sure.
You come from the world above. Is this the time of destiny, then? Is this a portent of the salvation of my people? Or merely another false sign to mislead us from the path? Are you the herald of prophecy? The beacon to guide us through the darkness? Or are you merely another harbinger of shattered dreams and unfulfilled promises?
Be careful. This one might be crazy enough to be dangerous.
Speak to me, Upworlder. Tell me what fate you unleash upon us. Salvation or damnation? Speak, Upworlder, I beg you! A question. You are uncertain, bewildered, perplexed. Understandable, I suppose. Even after 100 years of life, I myself still become confused at times. Perhaps I can make things more clear. Some things, at least. My name is Rukil. The oldest outcast here in the village. Rukil Wrinkleskin, the children call me sometimes. Once, I was honored for my wisdom. But over time, the villagers fell away from the true path. Eventually, there was only a single apprentice who followed me. And now she is gone, too.
No, not yet. I must be wary. Careful. You may be a false savior. Dare I share my secrets with you? No. Not until you prove yourself. My apprentice is lost. I sent her out into the Undercity to find... Well, I cannot tell you. Not yet. Sadly, my apprentice has not returned. Please, Upworlder, will you help an old man? Will you seek out my apprentice in the Undercity? Her name is Malia. I must know of her fate, whatever it may be. I must know what she found. Finding her may be difficult. Malia could be anywhere in the Undercity. But if you will find her, I will know you to be our true savior. Only then can I reveal my secret knowledge to you. I wish you luck, Upworlder. Come speak to me again once you have discovered the fate of my apprentice.
Greetings, Upworlder. We rarely see your kind here in the Undercity. I find it strange that so many of you have come down from the surface recently.
No offense, but I can see why people normally avoid this place.
Why have you come into this dark and sunless place? Is there something you need of me or my village? I will help you however I can. We are the outcasts, shunned from the surface for our crimes and banished here to the Undercity. We banded together to form this village that we might survive in this hostile environment. I am Gendar, leader of this village. As my father was, and as was his father before him. Many of us have been here for generations, our ancestors cast down long ago. There is no return to the surface for us or our descendants, but somehow we managed to survive amidst the filth and roaming bands of deadly Rakghouls. The Rakghouls are monsters, hideous mutations who feast on the flesh of our villagers. Their diseased jaws can infect those they attack, transforming the victim into one of those abominations. We know of no cure for the disease, and for the good of the village, we must banish any who become infected, lest they transform and turn on us. Ask your questions, Upworlder. I will answer to the best of my knowledge, though I know little beyond the borders of the Undercity. Yes, I have seen this Twi'lek many times, though I've never spoken to her. She and her Wookiee companion often pass through our village on their way to explore the sewers. There are two entrances into the sewers from the Undercity. One to the northeast of our village, the other to the southeast. But the sewers are dangerous, Upworlder. If you dare to travel those dark tunnels, you would be wise to go heavily armed, unless you wish to become a meal for the Rakghouls and the other foul creatures. Ask your questions, Upworlder. I will... The Rakghouls are... We know of no cure for the disease. Ask your questions, Upworlder. We are the outcasts, shunned from the surface for our crime. I am Gendar. There is no return to the surface. As you wish, Upworlder. Should you have need of anything else, come speak to me. I represent the entire village, and I will do my best to help you however I can.
You ain't from the village. You're from the Upworld, ain't you? Yes. You've got credits, I bet.
Watch yourself. There's something slimy about this guy. I wouldn't trust him as far as I could throw him.
My name's Sygir. I run a little salvage shop here. You want to buy something from my store? I got some good deals. If a villager comes across any useful salvage in the Undercity, they bring it to me. Every so often, members from the lower city gangs come down to trade for the salvage. They'll exchange food and medicine for engine parts, old blasters and the like. Sometimes they even give me credits if I have some really good stuff. Oh, you bet... Gendar seems to think I should share the profits of my store with the whole village. He figures... We're all in this together, so it should be share and share alike. But I'm the one who runs the store. I'm the one who makes the deals. The others just bring me salvage to trade with the Upworlders. Why should they get anything? Hey! You don't know what it's like down here. I have to claw and scrape to survive. Nobody else will look out for me. But Gendar doesn't agree with my philosophy. He caught me hoarding supplies a while back. I figured I'd wait until food was scarce and then I could offer it to people who'd follow me instead of Gendar. Then I'd be the leader. But Gendar made me share my hoard. Ever since then, he hasn't trusted me. He keeps me around because of my store, though. Without it, this village wouldn't stand a chance. It ain't the best stuff. Mostly...
Hurry, Hindar! Hurry! I can hear it coming!
He'll never make it. He's doomed. I told him he was a fool to leave the village.
He will make it. Run, Hindar! Run!
Open the gate! Quickly! There isn't much time!
I can't! The Rakkuls are too close!
The mutants will kill him if you don't open the gate!
And if I open the gate, they'll kill us all!
No! You can't do this! It isn't fair! Please, make him open the gate! Hindar will die if he doesn't!
I can't open the gate. Not while the Rakkuls are so near. You'd risk your life for a stranger? You're brave, Upworlder. I'll open the gate for you, but you gotta be quick. In a few seconds, I must close and lock it again.
Yes?
I can't thank you enough for saving me, Upworlder. If I had anything but these rags on my back, it would be yours. But we have nothing.
I still have you, Hindar. That's all I need. Let's go back to the village.
Thank you for saving Hindar. You are braver than I, Upworlder. Maybe we outcasts have lived too long in selfish fear. Perhaps we can learn a lesson from your brave actions. But enough of my ramblings. Is there something you need, Upworlder? I'm Trewin, from the outcast village. It's my job to guard the gates. And see they are locked to protect us from the Rakkuls. I just guard the gates. I'm Trewin. Goodbye, Upworlder.
Ready? What?
Please, you have to help me. Nobody else is gonna help me. Even the Bex won't help me. But I can't just leave him there. He's my friend. You'll help me, won't you? It's Zalbar. He's in trouble. Big trouble. We have to help him. If we don't, they'll sell him into slavery. Me and Zalbar, we were just wandering around here in the Undercity. You know, looking for stuff we could find, just kind of exploring. We do it all the time.
I guess with a Wookiee at your side, you've got to figure you can handle the odd Rakkul attack.
Only this time, they were waiting for us. Gamorrean slave hunters. We didn't even have a chance to run. Big Z threw himself at him and then roared for me to run. I took off. I figured Zalbar would be right behind me. But there were too many of them. He couldn't get away. They're going to sell him to a slaver, I just know it. I don't know for sure, but those Gamorreans like to hang out in the sewers. The stink reminds them of home, I guess. That's probably where they took Big Z. It's a deal. As soon as we get Big Z back, I'll show you a way into that Volker base. Now come on! We have to find Zalba before they sell him to slavers, or worse!
Do you know where he's being kept?
The Gamorreans make their camps in the sewers. I bet that's where we'll find Zalbar. And that's where I'll show you the secret entrance into the Volker compound.
You there, civilian. This is a restricted area. What are you doing down here? Security papers. Oh, you're one of those trackers the commander sent down, right? They should have given you an armed escort. It's nasty down here. We've already lost one patrol. We figure the Rak Ghouls got them. We've had so many encounters with those things, we've actually run out of Rak Ghoul serum. Plus, we've had several skirmishes with looters from those lower city swoop gangs. I'm telling you, we should just stay in the upper city where we're in control. Oh, is that why you're down here? Search and rescue. I didn't think they'd send anyone. They were in the southern section of the Undercity when we lost contact. I would have gone to investigate, but my orders are to search for those crashed escape pods, even if it means leaving another patrol to die. Hey, I'd never disobey my orders. I'm not a fan of court-martials and executions. I was just talking, you know. Nothing anyone has to mention to the commander. Come on, patrol, let's get back to it. The sooner we get this search done, the sooner we can get out of this mutant-infested hole. Move out!
Help me, please. I can feel it inside my skin. Something growing, like some kind of hideous disease. No! No! I can feel it!
Don't move. I'm not afraid to use this blaster if I have to.
Settle down, kid. We've already lost enough men to those damn rat ghouls. The last thing we need now is more casualties from a needless firefight. By the looks of you, I'd say you're down here for the same reason we are. To salvage something from those downed Republic space pods. Let me give you some advice. Forget about it. Do yourself a favor and just head back from where you came. This isn't a good place to stand around chatting. The Undercity is crawling with rat ghouls. I've already lost a half a dozen men to those monsters.
Candrus, I heard something. Over there, in the shadows. Sounded like a rat ghoul.
Looks like we've got company. Get those blasters ready, boys. I told Davik this salvage mission was a bad idea. His men aren't trained for this kind of thing, and I can't babysit them all. Okay, boys. We're getting out of here before I lose anyone else. I can't carry all this salvage back by myself. You'd be smart to get out of here as well. Even if you can handle the rat ghouls, I doubt there's anything worth finding anymore. Davik sent me down here with this motley crew to scavenge whatever we could from the Republic escape pods that crashed during the recent battle overhead. But the lower city gangs got here first. Anything worthwhile in those Republic pods is probably in their hands by now. Davik won't like that. What are you, an off-worlder? Everyone knows Davik. He's a member of the Exchange. You know, the Interstellar Crime Syndicate. Smuggling, gambling, extortion. Davik controls it all here on Taris. That's why I'm working for him. But lately, the lower city gangs have been giving my boss some trouble. This isn't really the best place to have these kinds of conversations, but I guess I could spare a couple of seconds for you. After all, you did help us out with those rat ghouls. The lower city is overrun with gangs, but the two most important ones are the Hidden Becks and the Black Vulkers. Used to be the Becks were the big dog and kept the others in line. But lately, the Black Vulkers are moving in on Beck turf and challenging them for control. The Vulkers are even starting to defy Davik. Take these escape pods, for example. Everyone knew Davik would want first crack at them. But I know for a fact those damn Vulkers have already sent their own salvage party down here. Come on, boys, let's move out!
What? You